Hi there, my name is Beth, and this is the story of how I renovated my 1904 Dutch sailing barge. This week, we're going to put the jobs on hold because we're off to the Netherlands. So we just arrived in Middelburg, and behind me is the boat that we're going to be sailing back across the channel back to London. This is True Hope, and this is Jago's boat, and you can see some of the crew getting ready here. So we just arrived maybe half an hour ago or something, so we need to wait for the police to come and check our passports to check us out of the UK. And then we're going to get some fuel and head off. So it's a bit of a flying visit to the Netherlands, but no. So we're just leaving Middelburg, and we just come to Stationsbrug, a swing bridge, and then in front of us is a huge big cantilever bridge. So you've had to wait for about an hour just on the landing there, and so we're heading through. So we're heading down to Vlissingen, or Flushing, where we're going to spend the night and then head off in the morning. So this one is, you might be able to see a swing bridge, might be able to see it closing behind me. But the lights are really cool. So there's green lights and red lights on the bridge. And two red light means don't come near. And then a green light and a red light means start to approach slowly. And then two green lights, or just a green light, means go straight through as quickly as you can. They're kind of different to the nav lights on the Thames, but we don't have bridges like this really, so it's fascinating. Canal now. We're going to moor up overnight, and then in the morning we're going to head for Britain. Well, this is absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. It's warm, sun shining. There's a little bit of wind now. When we were leaving Vlissingen, there was really no wind. We tried putting the sail up, foresail, and the boat was just slopping around, and the sail was just flogging backwards and forwards. So it didn't really work that well, so we dropped the sail again. But we were watching the wind indicator, the tell, on the top of the mast, and as we're slopping around, it kind of waves from side to side. But as soon as it kind of stays out when we're rocking side to side, then you can think there's probably enough wind for the sail. So yeah, so we pulled up the jib, the foresail, and yeah, we're probably doing about 4 knots now. And it's absolutely delightful. What a lovely day. What a great way of spending a Saturday. Wow. Beautiful. The only piece of land we can see now is some of Belgium, and Zeebrugge is just down here. Behind us is where we just come from the Netherlands. So we've come from over there. And then ahead of us, in the distance, on a heading of 270 degrees west, is Britain. And that's where we're going next. At this point the wind freshened and the seas started to increase, so we dropped sails and motored just at the right time. We then spent 8 tough hours bashing into the heavy southwesterly until we changed course for Ramsgate for shelter. So here we are in Ramsgate. We arrived at 3 a.m. This morning. We left Holland Dutch time at about just before 6 a.m. And then arrived here, it would have been 4 a.m. Dutch time, but 3 a.m. BST. So yeah, well, I think the last thing I filmed was us storming along with the sails up. Now after that, it all kind of went a little bit chaotic because we decided to, the wind was picking up a little bit, so we decided to drop the sails, which turned out to be a perfect time to do that because the sea really, really increased and the wind did as well. So we actually spent a good 8 hours banging into these massive waves and it was a little bit lumpy and a little bit uncomfortable. But so we came sort of directly, sort of west really from Middelburg, from Vlissingen. So it was almost due west all the way. We veered off a little bit to go through a huge big wind farm, and so we navigating through a wind farm with these huge big wind turbines at night was definitely interesting. But it was a really good experience. It's really good to do navigation like that, but, you know, line of sight navigation and chart plotting and stuff and taking bearings and all that kind of stuff. It's good to do that, and it was actually in anger because we were seriously, you know, going through quite narrow gaps between wind turbines. Anyway, I'm not going to ramble on too much because we have a bunch of jobs to do. So Troll Help we're now in Ramsgate. So this morning we've just been to have breakfast. And then we're going to leave the harbour, and it's about 5 or 6 nautical miles up to the top of the bottom of the Thames estuary. So we're going to turn into the Thames estuary, and we're going to follow the kind of southerly part because that takes us through a few little islands, and it kind of keeps us in the lee of the land because it's quite a strong southeasterly wind, but it's forecast to die off a little bit. So but it'll be okay. It might be a bit lumpy around the corner. Then we're going to head down to the estuary, and then we're going to get onto the Thames, just timing that perfectly for the tide so we can ride the tide up the estuary, up the river, and then we're going to moor at Greenwich. So hopefully it's not going to be too chaotic and I can film a bit more for you. Thank you. So I might keep this bit short. I've actually lost my voice a little bit. But here we are. We're in Greenwich. We moored up alongside the pontoon, which is owned by Greenwich Yacht Club. So yeah, what an amazing clubhouse that's behind me. And if I swing you around, then you can see the Emirates airline, which is going across the river. That's the gondola that goes across the river. And then maybe in the distance, you'll be able to see the supports of the Millennium Dome, the music venue. But yeah, so we arrived in quite late last night. We punched up the river as fast as we can to get the tide. We sailed it into the estuary, dropped the sail when we couldn't make the tack. And then we put the engine revs up and came flying up the Thames, which is amazing. It's an amazing trip, but yeah, still quite chaotic. But so it was about 9 o'clock. So we had 3 nights in a row. We had about 4 hours sleep. Last night we had about 6, so that's better. But I feel really tired. So this is where my part of the journey ends, and this is where I go home now. So it's not too long. I just need to get across town and then I can have a bit of sleep and a bit of food . So yeah, this week was a bit of an adventure really. And next week we're probably going to get back to more mundane tasks like doing the bilges. But I wanted to thank you for coming along with this journey with me. And thank you for all your kind comments and everything. Usually I don't ask you to subscribe because I'd much rather leave that to you, as that's your decision. But I would like to ask you, if you're enjoying this video or if you'd like to support my channel, maybe you'll consider subscribing because it really helped me. I'd like to bump the number up just a little bit more so I can get a few more features from YouTube. So if you'd consider subscribing, that would be really kind and I'd really appreciate that. And I think the bell icon lets you know when I've uploaded a video, but I do that on Thursdays anyway, so you probably know when that's going to come. So yeah, it's been a really eventful weekend, and next week we're just going to be doing a few more of the jobs. I'm going to try and finish that window frame, get the new window in, or get the old window in, I should say, and try and make a start on the bilges, because really I want the bilges done and I want the walls up before winter. So time is ticking. Thanks again for watching. Wherever you are, I hope you're safe, and I'll see you next time.